What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Marvelous Podcast. It's me, Kirsten, and I'm really excited about this subject matter we're going to talk about today. Yep, I said subject matter because I'm all professional and legitimate. Okay, so I had some really big aha moments, and I talk a little bit about this with my husband over on our podcast, The Strategy Masters, where we talk all things business. But I thought I would come to you, my people here, and chat about this because it was a really huge eye-opening weekend over the weekend. And I can't really say any one thing impacted this, but it was just like this, oh my gosh, I finally get it. And I can't believe I haven't gotten it sooner. So why not share that with y'all so that maybe if you have, and maybe this will just be one little piece that helps your eyes to become open to this. It may not be the moment for you, but it might be one of the pieces of the puzzle. And that really boils down to this awareness of like, there is truly no right or wrong way to do things. And I know there's like right and wrong, good and bad, right? But that is so subjective. And so my experience, and I'm speaking specifically about social media, and I've been using social media for business for the last 4.5 years. So really trying to be intentional with it, but I've also used it as a person for a lot much longer than that, 10 years, right? Like I think I'm longer. I got a Facebook account when Ben and I met. It was when Facebook was still really new. So 12 years, we're coming up on our 12th anniversary. So I've been using social media as a consumer, as a creator, just for people for a long time, but as a business, not for as long. Now, when you do it for business, when you step into that, you start to create a different awareness because you pay attention to the back end. You're not just paying attention to, oh, I love that and I like that and I want to pay attention to that and that makes me feel happy and all of those kinds of things. As an entrepreneur, you start looking at it from kind of a strategic approach where you're like, I want to understand how that engagement is happening. I want to understand how they're growing. I want to look at the analytics. I want to learn and I want to implement that for myself. So I've attended trainings. I've gone to workshops. I've watched multiple videos. I've paid for programs. I've been part of memberships for a really long time that helped me to curate the proper content. And I'm doing air quotes with proper, right? And finally, recently, I've been like, you know what? I appreciate all of those things. I'm not saying I wish I would never would have learned those things. But there's a problem with learning a lot of stuff without having your own mind and your own way to translate that into an applicable, useful tool for your own benefit. So for example, I went to a workshop once and you know, the advice I heard was don't post pictures of your kids. Your people don't know who your kids are. So as they're scrolling, they're not going to stop on them because they don't know who they are. And so I took that to heart and I made that decision of, okay, I need to just post myself. I need to post business related things. If I post my kids, people aren't going to know that it's me. They're not going to like the photo. They're not going to comment. It's not going to help me grow, right? Because that's the rule. I'm hearing this from a guru. I'm hearing this from somebody who has, you know, lots and lots of followers who's been doing this much longer than me. So if she says it, then I better do it that way. And now I look back after, I don't even know how long it's been since I did that. And I'm like, I regret that so much. And it's not that I never posted. If you go to my Instagram, you'll see like I definitely post pictures of my kids, but it became so much less frequent than it used to be. It used to really be where I was kind of creating this like lifestyle situation and I wanted to show my life. I homeschool my kids and they're very much a part of my day-to-day life, but I felt like I had to create this divide. I was trying to do it right, you know? And I think a lot of times we do this where we start following somebody else's set of prescribed rules and we slowly over time, we lose our own mind. We lose our own way of thinking and we stop being intuitive with the things that we want to create in our life. And this isn't just like a businessy approach. This is with everything. This is not knowing your own mind and your own heart when it comes to raising your kids. This is not knowing your own mind and your heart when it's time to create and do things that you feel compelled to do that you're in love with doing. Because you start looking at the technical. It's like from a music standpoint, right? And I've talked about this a little bit before on the episode Singing Again, how I know that I love to sing. I know that music is a part of my heart and soul, and I know it's a way that I can express myself in a way that not everybody can. But yet I assign all of the rules. I assign the rules of like, well, my range needs to be this. I need to be able to do this many things with my voice. I need to be able to have these connections with people. I need to have this much time. It's got to be a sacrifice. I have to be a starving artist, blah, 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 right? And I start assigning all these rules to something that should innately just flow and be natural. And that's not to confuse it with you have to do work. You have to hone the craft. You have to polish the skill so that it can become more than just this little thing that you do, like more than just singing nursery rhymes to your kids. If you want to express yourself that way, it's totally appropriate to learn how. It's great to take programs and courses. They're going to teach you how to do the things that you want to do with your talent. The problem becomes when you are taking that advice and you're making it the law, you're making it the end all be all, and you're forgetting that you, my friend, have an inner compass of your own, that you are called and compelled to do things that may not make sense or fit into somebody else's formula. And I'm seeing this emerge more and more and more with people where we're starting to be like, why? Why do I have to do it that way? And ironically, a lot of times we're putting a lot of stock and trust in people who are teaching us something that probably does work for a lot of people. It worked for them, maybe. I think a lot of times with like education and courses and stuff that we take, people are trying to reverse engineer a process they did and recreate it for other people. But I see a lot of lack of duplication happening. And I've personally experienced that in my life where I've had this monumental success and I've reverse engineered it and I've tried to create a formula for people to follow. But when it came down to it, even if they did my exact steps and they followed this perfect plan, it wasn't going to work for them because they were not being intuitive. I've coached women in business who are doing all the things they should be, air quotes, should be, right? It's like the only downfall of a podcast. Y'all can't see my hand motions and I feel like I have to dictate. It's like a script when you have the little words that say the action that is happening or the emotion, which at least you can hear my emotion. You just can't see what I'm doing with my face or my hands. So the imagination is yours. Anyway, we have these things we're supposed to do. And I've coached women, like I said, who have done this. They've gone through all of the things. They've checked all the boxes. They're creating the content. They're building the email list. They're doing all the things, but it's still not working. And it's like this emotional thing where I just kind of want to just pass on a piece of my heart and soul and say, don't you feel it right here? Get out of here. I'm pointing to my head. Get out of your brain and get into your heart. Get into your soul. Get into the emotional, driven, intuitive part of you. Are you doing the right things? Just because I said that's what I do and that's what's working for me, is that the right thing for you? Are you showing up on the right platforms to share who you are? Are you educating people in a way that feels natural to you? And this is different than just the fear of showing up 100%. This is a matter of showing up 100%, but not in the authentic way that makes sense. So when you look at something, for example, like social media and how the content I've been sharing is trying to fit into a formula, we pay so much attention to analytics if we're posting at the right time. If the engagement is low, then obviously that's not what people want to hear. And the people who have success on social media, they don't care. I mean, they might care, but they don't let that dictate how much content they create. They don't say, well, I mean, guys, I've done this. Well, that only got 12 likes. I guess people don't want to hear from me. I guess I'll disappear for a month. That's not true. I don't know what's going on in cyberspace. I don't know what's happening with algorithms. I don't know what's happening with people. Maybe it didn't resonate with them, but maybe it's not so much about when I posted or the photo I used. Maybe it's about what I'm trying to share. Am I sharing what I really needed to share that day? And if so, like if it was a really intentional post, do I still care enough about the maybe one person who saw it and learned from it to keep showing up for that one person? Or am I focusing too much on how this is going to look for me? And if it only matters if I reach 10,000 people, 20,000, 50,000 people, you know what I mean? But we get so caught up in the rules in the game that we're trying to play that we fail to be who we are meant to be for people. We fail to be intentional. We fail to be inspiring because we're so worried about doing it wrong. We're so led by fear. And so that's my huge aha moment that I had over this last week is like, I'm so done. And it's not like I'm done caring about what other people think. I kind of hate that phrase. Like we always care about what people think because we want to be good humans and not that we want to be judged or that we care. I think there's a positive way that we're trying to say that, right? Like we don't care if people are judging us negatively, but we care how we impact people, or at least we should. We should care how we're making people feel when we create content, when we talk to people, when we show up in our lives. We should care. We should care. And if we care, and if we are led by the caring and the emotional component, and then we find these things and we find what fits into our situation. I could have gone to that workshop and been like, you know what? That's great for her. It doesn't really make sense to me. Because that's so much a part of who I am. And that is something that even if it doesn't get the most likes or it doesn't help my numbers grow, I wouldn't be me 100% if I didn't share that. So I'm still going to do it. And be a little stubborn. Own your space. Don't let anybody tell you that you're doing it wrong. Because I've seen people succeed in a massive way by doing it wrong. So that just tells me that there is no actual marker for right and wrong when it comes to how you do your life, how you do your business. I mean, we know murder is morally wrong, right? We know it's good to do good things for people. What I'm talking about is in all of the things that we're trying to create and do, the way you parent is not wrong. The way I parent is not wrong. The way you school your children is not wrong, right? The person you married is not wrong because he's different than the man I chose to marry, and vice versa. So stop allowing other people's outlines for life dictate the way that you live yours. Just show up and do what you feel called and compelled to do. And even at the end of the day, if that takes a longer time to grow, you are going to be so much more proud of what you build in your life if you're doing it from the place of, I know I'm supposed to do it this way. Okay? Thank you for listening, you guys, and I'll see you on the next episode. Have a marvelous day.